Sports Designers, we are back again. Mike with Sports Templates here, and I've got another amazing soccer template for you today. I'm going to show you how to use this template to create this USA fixed design soccer jersey. We know that the USA kit for World Cup was recently released and it didn't receive great reviews, so I thought I'd throw together a quick fix design that I thought would be better. And we're going to go through that today using this new template from Sports Templates. As always, before we get started, make sure you head down below, hit those like and subscribe buttons, and you'll also find a link to the asset library used in this design so you can follow along. So you'll see that up here. We've got the color library and some logos that we're going to use for this design. I usually forget to mention this, so please drop us a comment. Let us know what you'd like to see in the future, what you think about this design, what you think about this template. We'd just like to hear from you. So, okay, before we get started on this USA fix design, let me show you everything you get with this template, okay? So, we've already seen this view. This is the main view, we'll call it, of the soccer jersey. You also get the reverse view and the back view. So, if you want to show multiple angles, show two teams head-to-head using the two opposite angles, you can do that. Show the back of the jersey. And the two front views include five different collar styles. So we have one that's we're calling no collar because it's really not a separate collar piece. It's just kind of the end of the fabric there. The round collar, the polo collar with buttons, the V-neck, and a stand-up collar. So tons and tons of options within this template to match all the different styles of jerseys out there on the market if you're trying to replicate designs or just have a certain one that you prefer for your designs. Lots of options here. All of this in 7K resolution. So you can zoom in, and we'll do that real quick just to take a look. You can zoom in and see all of the fine detail of the fabric. You can see the texture of the fabric, the different texture of the numbers and the logos that you put on there with the shadows, texture of the collar material all the way around. There's even a tag down here, and we'll show you how to use that later. The seams on the jerseys. And that's another thing I want to show you real quick before we get started. Some of these jerseys that are out there on the market have different seam patterns on them you might want to utilize. So for this one, we have the sleeve seam turned on. So you can see the sleeve there has a seam on it. So if you didn't want that, you could turn that off, have more of a continuous flow of the fabric. You can also turn on the straight seam and have a seam going across here. Or you can turn on the round seam and have one going across here. So several different options with the seams as well. So I'm going to go ahead and zoom back out. Let's get started on making our USA fix design. We'll show it to you one more time. And let's get into it. So for that design, we are going to be utilizing this asset library, which I mentioned is down in the comments or the description section of the video. So you can go ahead and download that, follow along. I'm going to start at the bottom. We're going to go into our background folder, and we're going to set our background color. I don't want the color to be completely white. I want it to be a little bit of a contrast from the color of the jersey, which is going to be white. So I'm going to set it to this blue, but I don't want it to be that dark either. So I'm going to edit that color, and I'm just going to kind of get somewhere here in this white, blue, gray area. Maybe down here just a little bit more, get a little more blue into it. Maybe something like that. And then let's change the text in the background. So the big text here, we can just change that. We'll put USA, and then down here, we'll put soccer. Okay, save that. And you can also, down here, you can turn the shadows off, the highlights for the lighting. And in this folder here, you can also change the text, Sports Templates Presents, and Photoshop Mockup. You can change all that, and you can also turn off that logo if you wanted to. So lots of options there. So now let's get into the jersey editable parts. We're gonna go into this folder here and just start setting our colors and our different designs. So I'm gonna take all of these color fill layers, I'm gonna hold down Control, and I'm gonna check each one. This one's already white, but I'm gonna check it anyway. And I'm going to click this color here to set all of those to white. And we're going to change that later, but I'm just kind of setting the foundation, turning things white. If we work our way up, we see quite a few things. Now we have jersey back design here. Now, this is what controls this part of the design inside here. And there's actually multiple options for this. This one is if you were using no collar. So if I turn that off, you're not going to notice a change, because up here in my collars folder in the round collar, we have a separate for that. Okay. I'm going to come up here and I'm going to go into my round collars folder. I'm going to set all of these to white as well. And while we're here, let's go ahead and change that jersey back design. So I'm going to turn off my grid. I'm going to set my background color to white. I'm going to hit Control or Command J to duplicate, duplicate the background layer. I'm going to turn it blue, and I just want to create kind of this arch on the back that we saw in the reference. So I'm going to get my path selection tool, make sure I choose that path, get my curvature pen tool, and I'm just going to come down here to the center point, add an anchor point, and I'm just going to drag that up. And then I'm going to change the shape to make the curve kind of less dramatic. I'm going to hold down shift and kind of just drag this up maybe to about the midway point there. And I'm going to hit Control or Command S to save it and kind of see how it looks. And it actually looks pretty much exactly how I want it, so I'm going to leave it just like that. And let's move on to, while we're up here, let's just go ahead and take care of the rest of the collar. So we do have a smart object for the neck stripe design. So let's just zoom in. I'm hitting Control and Plus on my keyboard to zoom in, and then I'm going to hold the space bar so I can use a little hand there and drag. So you can put a design along the inner stripe here inside the neck. We're not going to do that for this design, so I'm going to turn that off. And we actually don't have a collar design either, so we've got a couple smart objects here for our inner collar and our outer collar designs if you want to do stripe pattern or something like that. I'm going to turn both of those off too, because we're just going to have a white collar for this one. Okay, so now we're done up here in the collar area. If you did want to change the collar, this is where you would do it. So if you didn't want a round collar and you wanted a polo collar, you could turn that on and also turn on the shadow to give it some more realism. Same thing with the stand-up collar, and same thing with the V-neck collar. So all your options are there. We're going to stick with the round collar for this one. And now we're done with collars. Let's go back down to our main editable parts folder. And let's get into the jersey design. So I'm going to hit Control 0 just to zoom out to full screen. And I'm going to go into this jersey design. And so this is to do all the parts where we see the blue grid here. This is to do any design on the jersey where it's a sublimated design. It's not like the sewn on letters or the embossed letters that have the different texture and the thicker detail. This is just something that would be printed directly on the fabric of the jersey. There's a few options in here too, by the way. I'm going to go ahead and turn off the main grid. I'm going to set my background color to the white because that's the color of the jersey anyway. And before we set up the design, I want to show you a few options in here. So we do have a grid here for if you're using the straight seam that I showed you earlier. So anything up here in the white would be above that seam, and it has a little curve to it because the jersey itself has a curve to it. And same thing here with the round seam. If you want to design above that seam line, you can stay in the white space here. And then we also built in this triangle design, which I'll show you real quick. I'm going to set it to this dark blue, hit Control or Command S to save it. And if we go up here, we have this design on the front. And so if we turn on our round seam, it's going to fit right with that. And then if you go to your round collar, and you go to the collar design here on the front, there's actually a built-in thing here. It's called Stripe for Collar Design, or I'm sorry, Stripe for Triangle Design. And this is already set up for you to line up with that front triangle. So I'm gonna hit Control or Command H just to hide my controls there. And you can see now, that's perfectly lined up so that if you wanted to do one of those types of designs that fits with the seam and kind of lines up with the collar, you can do that. I'm going to go ahead and turn that off because we're not going to be utilizing that for this particular design, but I just wanted to show you how to do that. So we'll go back in here and we'll just turn that off, and we'll go back in here and turn that off. Now for this, we do want to set up our stars and stripes pattern that we saw on the sample. So that's the chest design here. I'm just going to drag that in, and it's already sized appropriately. I'm not going to take the time to show you how I made this particular element, but not too difficult to make. I'll just drag this up a bit. I'm going to try to line it up with, okay, that's actually pretty much exactly where I want it when looking at the reference image. These stripes here were kind of just past the top shoulder seam. I forgot to turn off that round seam too, so I'm going to do that as well, because we don't want that for this design, so we'll turn that off. And then we have another smart object here for side panel design. So if you wanted to do a separate design on this side here, it's kind of like the jersey is floating in the wind, and maybe the side is kind of folded over. So this would be an opportunity to put, you know, a stripe pattern or some other pattern on the side if you want to. But we're just going to turn that off. And then let's get into the sleeves. So left sleeve color, we'll leave that white. The cuff, we're going to make this side red, and we're going to make this side blue. And then these sleeve designs we're going to turn off, because these are, again, these are the sublimated designs that are not like the embossed logos or the stitched on logos. And to get to those, we're going to go up into our embossed logo and graphics folder. We're just going to open that up, go down to the purple color indicated folder where it says add your design here, open that up, and we have our sleeve design on the left with our depth. And so we're going to open that smart object. And for this one, I don't want to keep the background color on, because this is going to display as a different material that's attached onto the surface of the jersey. And so I don't want the full background to be filled in, because it's going to add a completely different texture to the entire sleeve. And I just want to add the texture to the logo. So I'm going to drop in this World Cup Qatar logo that I made for this asset library, and hit Control or Command S to save it. And then if you come out here, you can see now it's been added to our sleeve. And let's just zoom in and see. So we can see all this nice jersey texture. And then here we've got the nice sort of patch texture, and we can see it's got the shadow on it. So there's some depth here. We can tell that that's attached to the surface of the jersey rather than printed onto the material. Go ahead and hit Control or Command 0 to back out. And now let's place our number and logo on the front chest as well. So in that same folder, we're going to go to this one that's add your design here, and that's for the embossed number and logo that's going to be on the chest. It's going to close these out to save some space. Let's double click into there. So for this one, we don't need these preset numbers and logos that are in here. We're just going to turn those off. I did want to show you down here, we have this badge, the authentic badge. So this is like the jock tag on the front of the jersey. And it's got the year 2022 on it, but if you wanted to change the year to something else, you can change this 2 to a 3 or whatever you want to do. I'm going to leave it as a 2 for now. And of course, you can just turn this off if you don't want that on the front. Let's hit Control 0 to zoom back out. And then let's just drop in our, actually not this USA logo. I preset this one with the numbers on it, and it should be sized appropriately. So we're going to drop this in. I'm just going to kind of guess where I want it. And I actually want to line this up about here, centering the logo on our center grid line. I'm going to hit Control or Command S to save, and I'm just going to see where it ended up. Okay, so it's a little high. We need to bring it down in order to kind of align with the bottom of our sublimated design. So I'm going to hold the Shift key while I drag this down, so it only moves down and it doesn't move left or right. And then I'm going to hit Control or Command S again to save and see where we ended up. And that is perfect. It's exactly where we wanted it, lining up with the bottom. We've got our numbers on here. And if we zoom in, We can see the texture on the numbers. We can see the USA logos on there. We can see the texture on the USA logo itself versus the texture of the sublimated design, which again is like printed directly on the jersey. So it looks quite a bit different. So we hit Control or Command Zero to back all the way out. There's the finished product. So we've got a great design, all completed and pretty quickly, right? You can imagine how quick this would be if I wasn't necessarily narrating and telling you what to do. So very easy to use template, lots of great options to make your designs look really, really cool. So one last thing to show you before we finish this off is the some of the other features that come with these. One of the main ones that makes sports templates just some of the best on the market by far is the dynamic lighting option. So the dynamic lighting option is actually, there's several options built into this template. This is the main one here that adds additional lighting to the entire surface of the jersey. You can kind of see it turning on and off there. Now, if you want to make that more extreme or just kind of change the angles, you can go into the dynamic lighting smart object. And I like to start here on the hue saturation, go to the properties. If you just drag this hue slider left and right, you can dramatically change the light. And you'd notice it more on like a dark color rather than a white jersey. So let's do something kind of extreme so you can really see it. So I'm gonna hit Control or Command S. And now you can see the jersey looks a lot lighter, right? And that's affecting everything that's in there. Let's make the jersey a dark color just so you can see, really see the difference. Okay, that's not gonna work because inside my jersey design folder, I have a white background. So let me turn that off. Okay, so now you see on a dark blue jersey, the dynamic lighting, you know, really makes a big difference. Now this is a really extreme example. You may not wanna do anything quite like that, but you can move these around and really kind of play with different lighting scenarios to fit your scene. See the difference there? So we'll turn that off. Go ahead and turn my jersey back to white. So that is everything that you get in this template. There's also some dynamic lighting folders within each collar. So if you wanted to change the lighting just on the collar, you could do that as well. So lots of great options. So I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. I hope you had as much fun as I did. You can really do so much with these templates and the realism is just pretty insane when you scroll in here. Just hitting Control or Command Plus on my keyboard, get real close view. Look at all that amazing detail in the texture, the lighting, the shadows. That tag just looks amazing. Lots and lots of great details on here. So hopefully you had fun. Hopefully you learned something. You can pick this template up over at sportstemplates.net. And don't forget to go down, hit the like and subscribe buttons. Leave us a comment. Let us know what you think. Thank you so much for watching, and we will see you next time.